Hey there, my name is Kaylee, and this lesson is on action and reaction forces. It will be helpful that you've already completed the modules Newton's first law and Newton's second law before starting this one. We often think that forces happen to an object. When I push against a heavy box, I'm exerting a force onto the box. But the box is also exerting a force onto me. And this is because forces come in pairs called action-reaction-force pairs. Let's do a quick example. Take your hand and exert a downward force by pushing it down against the table. What does your hand look like? It gets a bit distorted, right? A little smushed when you're pushing down on the table. And this is because while you're pushing a force down onto the table is also exerting a force back up on you. You're pushing down on the table, and the table pushing back on you is an example of action-reaction force pairs. We can't feel the force that we're exerting onto the table, but we do feel the force the table is pushing back onto us. Now let's focus on a more complex example of action-reaction force pairs. When a hammer strikes a nail to push it into a piece of wood, we know the hammer is exerting a force onto the nail. The striking of the hammer is downwards and exerts a downward force onto the nail. And what happens to the nail? From Newton's second law, we know that an unbalanced force on the nail will cause it to move, and the nail accelerates downward and goes into the wood. But that same downward force that the hammer exerts on the nail is exerted upwards on the hammer. And this might feel hard to understand since the hammer doesn't accelerate back up in the air, but in fact, it does. Newton's second law affects everything, and the upward force exerted by the nail on the hammer will cause the hammer to accelerate upwards in the direction of the unbalanced force. But the hammer is very heavy, and the nail, not very heavy. So even though they are experiencing the same force, they will experience different accelerations. Since the hammer is so much heavier than the nail, the hammer will barely even notice, if at all, the acceleration. So what seems like a big force on a little object like the nail will seem like a small force on a big object like the hammer. Now we're going to play a game where we find the action-reaction force pairs in different pictures. The first picture. This is the Apollo 11 spacecraft at the moment of liftoff. Do you see where there would be an action-reaction force pair that causes the rocket to lift off the ground? The spacecraft exerts a downward force on the ground by pushing fuel exhaust out of the bottom of the rocket. That's what all that white stuff is that looks like smoke. But this downward force from the exhaust pushes back up onto the spacecraft, and this causes the spacecraft to have an unbalanced force pointing upwards. And if we use Newton's second law, we know that an unbalanced force will cause the rocket to accelerate. And this is how the rocket has liftoff. And the same laws affect the Earth. But luckily for us, the Earth is much heavier than the rocket, so we on Earth don't notice the acceleration due to the downward force of the fuel exhaust. Nice job. Now let's try another picture. This is a cannon that has just fired a cannonball. It is clear that the cannon has exerted a left and upward force on the cannonball, and that's why it's now hurtling through the air. But the cannonball also exerted a force in the opposite direction on the cannon itself. And this force causes something that is called recoil. It's the backward movement of a thing that outputs a projectile or launches something. The cannon will actually roll a small ways back from the unbalanced force. Great job studying action and reaction forces. Now see if you notice any of these types of force pairs in your life. Some ideas to get you started are jumping off a diving board, skateboarding, and kayaking. Have fun! Remember to always be clever! Hey, hey.